On behalf of the General Assembly, I have the honor to welcome to the United Nations His Excellency Gotabaya Rajapaksa, President of the Democratic Socialist Republic of Sri Lanka, and to invite him to address the Assembly.
Mr. President, Secretary General, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, Ayubowan. I'm honored to represent Sri Lanka at this August gathering today. Let me first congratulate His Excellency Abdullah Shaheed on being elected President of the 76th session of the General Assembly. Mr. President, you have long been a friend of Sri Lanka. We look forward to working closely with you in the year ahead. I also take this opportunity to convey our appreciation of His Excellency Volkan Bozkurt's stewardship of the previous session of the General Assembly and to commend Secretary General Antonio Guterres for his leadership in these difficult times. The COVID-19 pandemic has had a devastating impact on humanity. I sympathize deeply with all who have lost their loved ones during the pandemic. I thank frontline healthcare and essential workers around the world for their dedication and commend the World Health Organization for its crisis response. Although still a developing nation, Sri Lanka has been very successful in its vaccination program. We have already fully vaccinated nearly all those above the age of 30. Everyone over the age of 20 will be fully vaccinated by the end of October. We will start vaccinating children over 15 years of age in the near future. The rapid progress of vaccinations was enabled by coordinated efforts between healthcare workers, armed forces, and police personnel, government servants, and elected officials. In collaboration with the WHO, Sri Lanka is establishing a regional knowledge hub to facilitate exchange of lessons learned from COVID-19 and support countries to recover better. Mr. President, the economic impact of the pandemic has been especially severe on developing countries. This has placed the implementation of the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development Goals at considerable risk. It is vital that more initiatives, including development financing and debt relief, be adopted through international mechanism to support developing nations and help them emerge from this uncertain situation. Sri Lanka too has suffered greatly due to the pandemic. Tourism, one of Sri Lanka's highest foreign exchange earners and a sector that supports nearly 14% of the population, has been devastated. This industry, together with small and medium businesses in many other sectors, received government support through interest moratoriums and other financial sector interventions. Daily wage earners and low-income groups were also supported through grants of cash and dry rations during lockdowns, adding significantly to state expenditure. Mr. President, as devastating as the consequences of the pandemic have been to humanity, the world faces the even greater challenge of climate change in the decades to come. As a climate-vulnerable country, Sri Lanka is deeply aware of the dangers of climate change. It is in this context that Sri Lanka is a Commonwealth Blue Charter champion and leads the Action Group on Mangrove Restoration. Through the adoption of the Colombo Declaration on Sustainable Nitrogen Management, which seeks to have nitrogen waste by 2030, Sri Lanka has also contributed to global efforts to reduce environmental pollution. My government completely banned the use of chemical fertilizers, pesticides and weedicides earlier this year. Production and adoption of organic fertilizer as well as investments into organic agriculture are being incentivized. In 2019, Sri Lanka experienced the devastation wrought by extremist religious terrorists in the Easter Sunday attacks. Before that, until 2009, it had suffered from a separatist terrorist war for 30 years. Terrorism is a global challenge that requires international cooperation, especially on matters such as intelligence sharing, if it is to be overcome. Violence robbed Sri Lanka of thousands of lives and decades of prosperity in the past half century. My government is committed to ensuring that such violence never takes place in Sri Lanka again.